Praise God. I'll tell you, I've known Connie and Dwight for over 30-something years. And I was introduced to them by a friend of mine, a friend of theirs.
In kindergarten, huh?
No, not that far. His name was Steve Collins. And he was an awesome 12-string guitar player. And I wasn't a Christian at that time. I'd known God because I was electrocuted when I was 15. And, you know, God got me off the electric pole when I woke up. I was laying on the ground with my two hands crossed over my chest. And this was in the Bahamas. And, you know, I've known God a long time, but I was rebelling. I wanted to live my own life. And then I got into drugs. And when I got into drugs, you know, God dealt with me. You know, he let me know that he was boss over my life. And he let me know the power that he has. Because I should have been dead a long time ago, many times. But I thank God that I met Dwight and Connie through through Steve. And they have done a lot in my life also. They have touched me. They have planted seeds in my life. Because I remember the good times when we used to go out and praise and worship. We'd go to these, what do you call them? Not Pentecostal, but full gospel churches. Didn't even have no music, but they would just, you know, sing a cappella and clap their hands and praise, and they would set it up so we would go down and praise at their churches. And this was like way up in the woods, you know. And it was awesome. At the end of the praise and worship, they'd have a big old table full with fried chicken, greens and stuff. You know, it was awesome. But I want to just say that I love Dwight and Connie, and they have meant so much to me. They tried to get me to come to church a long time ago, and to, you know, with them. And at that time, I guess I wasn't ready yet. But you know, God, He brings us back in a 360-degree circle. He brings us where He wants us to be, and He had a plan for me when I first started out. When I first started out, praise and worshiping at a full gospel church, and I played there for 4 years, and God touched me there. But their church was, you know, they had certain rules that you had to go by. You had to wear long dresses, and you know, it was just the way they handled stuff. I didn't like it. You know, I didn't feel that was right. And when I came back and met Connie and Dwight, I told them the other day. I said, "This is the last stop for me," because I've been in four different churches, and I said, "This is my last stop." And this is where I'll be, and I'll be staying here. And I say this in the name of the Lord also. Yeah, I love you guys. I love everyone in here. And this is awesome church. You know, the praise and worship, man, you can't beat it. You know, it's awesome. It lifts my spirit every time. Praise God. I should have said something about her.
That's all right. Okay, I just wanted to let y'all know we've been here for 2 years now, and I love this church. I've known Connie and Dwight since 1981, so I met them about maybe a year or so after Ace met them. And over the years, it's runs in my family severe depression, and I didn't think that I could ever overcome it. I had been prayed for probably 100 times over the years, and it just never went away. I don't know whether I didn't have faith or whether it wasn't time or what was going on. But January 2nd of this year, I went for counseling. I went and talked with Bill and Nancy.
Thank you, Bill.
And they gave me the materials to use. And at first, it felt like I was just reading words on a paper. And I'm like, now how, you know, I'm so distracted. How is this ever going to get into my mind, you know, because I would be reading, and I would even read out loud, and it just didn't seem like it was going anywhere. But God was doing something so gradual, I just did not even know when it happened. But I have very, very, very few times since then, since January 2nd, that I've really been down. It's really been a blessing, and if I hadn't came here, this wouldn't have happened. Because I had been prayed for just, I don't know how many times over the years, and just nothing ever happened. But I just want to thank the Lord for this church, for this place, and y'all know how to have fun here. I've learned to have fun again, because I didn't think it was possible. But I've had more fun in the last 2 years than I've had my, and I don't know how long. But I just thank the Lord for this place.